a central issue. There is no alternative to the two-state solution, and Jerusalem is key to any peace agreement, and it is key to the stability of the entire region. I did re-emphasize to the U.S. President yesterday our concerns on the decision to move the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem. Therefore, it is imperative now to work fast to reach a final status solution and a peace agreement between Palestinians and Israelis.
That news conference, which took place just a short while ago, and the message there very clear. Joining us from Jerusalem is BBC Arabic's Issam Ikirmawi. Issam, thank you very much for joining us. What's your assessment of the likely impact of this announcement today?
Well, the Palestinian Authority has come out against the moving of the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. They made it clear that they're not happy with the decision and that President Trump should only take such a decision if there was a comprehensive agreement between the Israelis and the Palestinians, and that East Jerusalem is recognized as the capital of the future Palestinian state. They see this unilateral decision by President Trump as a setback for his own efforts to kickstart the peace process. The American administration has been working on the so-called the ultimate deal between the Israelis and the Palestinians, and there have been reports that this deal will be announced sometime early next year. However, this latest announcement by President Trump to move the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem and to recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, according to the Palestinians and many Arab states, is a setback to these efforts.
Is there surprise at the timing of it? Because lots of people have known what President Trump's view on this has been for quite a while, but we had Professor Schlem talking to us just a while ago saying that the timing couldn't be worse in many ways. What's the view there on the timing of this?
Yes, absolutely. Many people are surprised by the timing, considering that their Jared Kushner and Jason Greenblatt have been going back and forth, touring the region, talking to the Palestinians, the Israelis and other Arabs for the last few months, trying to work out some kind of agreement. Now, President Trump has decided to go ahead with moving the embassy just shorts before, weeks before this new initiative is due to be announced. Many have been taken by surprise. It was expected that he would sign the waiver, which himself has signed once before, and former presidents have been signing since 1995 when Congress